Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here, and in this video, we're going to be discussing output and a few other miscellaneous features with C++. Let's get into it. First things first, I want to discuss with you guys the use of namespaces. In programming, we can't have variables, functions, and other things with the same name. So to avoid that from happening, we can use a namespace. Different namespaces allow us to reuse the same names for things as long as they are within a different namespace. We can reuse that same name in a different namespace. In our standard output, we are saying that we are using the standard namespace for our output, and it can be annoying to have to type std before every line, but there's a trick that we can use where we don't have to write this every time. So outside of your main method, this is what we're going to type. Type using namespace std. So this is telling the C++ compiler that just assume everything here is using this namespace, so we no longer have to type this out explicitly, and this will work just the same then. Next, let's discuss the return zero statement that you might see at the end of a main method. So programs may calculate or process something and return a result. What you may see at the bottom of many functions in C++ is this return keyword, and they usually return some sort of value. At the bottom of your main function, we're going to want to return zero. And this isn't necessary, but I'll explain what this does in just a moment. So in C++, this is sometimes referred to as the exit status. What this does is that our program, if it runs fine without any errors, it will return zero. And this is like a success status, like saying the program ran fine with zero errors. However, this is only required in C programs. It's optional in C++. The compiler automatically adds a return zero if we don't explicitly write this. But in case you do see this, this is what this means. Let's move on to line breaks. When we write output statements, our output will only add a line break if we explicitly let the compiler know that we intend it to. So for example, let's remove these new line characters and see what happens when we run the program. So our output is all in one long run-on sentence. It's all on the same line, even though our code is in two different separate statements. So you have to let the compiler know that you intend to break this line and go down to the next line as if you're hitting enter. And there's actually two ways to do this. The first is that we covered it in the first lesson. You just use the new line character, and I'll get into this more in depth later on in this video. The other way is that we can add these two left angle brackets, and these are sometimes referred to as the insertion operator. They basically pass along data and then add end L, then semicolon, and this is short for end line, but make sure you take out that other semicolon. And this will work just the same then, so let's add that here as well. So this is another way of writing what we had before. Each has their own uses. Yeah, and you can see that each line has a line break and shifts down to the next line after it's finished. The second option to use a line break is to use backslash n, which is what we did previously, but I'll explain this more in detail. So the backslash portion is part of something called an escape sequence. Depending on what character that we add after the backslash, it will have a certain effect on our output. If we add backslash n, it will add a new line. And for example, if I add backslash n before each of these words, it's actually going to print each of these words on a new line. So let's try it out. Yeah, and you can see that changed our output. So you can use this escape sequence for a new line anywhere you want within here. And there's other escape sequences as well besides new line, like backslash t is for tab. So let's try that out. So this will add a tab before each word, and you can tap things and space things. If you need to write a set of quotes, like you're quoting something, you might have trouble because your program won't know where our string of characters begins and where our string of characters ends then. So you can use an escape sequence to add some quotes, which is backslash and then single quote or double quote. So if you want to like quote something, like we're quoting lyrics to a song here, you could just add backslash and then a set of double quotes. And let's try this out. And you can see that our first line is now within quotes as if we're quoting something. And for some reason, if you need to print out a backslash, you actually have to type double backslashes, and let's try that out. And here's our backslash. Because remember, if you have just a single backslash, the compiler thinks it's a beginning of an escape sequence. So if you need to print it out, you need double backslashes. So those are a few of the basic escape sequences that you should be aware of. There's still many more out there, and if you have time, I would suggest looking through online to see what else is out there, if there's any that would be relevant for you. But those are just a few of the basics before we really start to dive into programming with C++. Lastly, for this video, we are going to discuss comments. Comments are a portion of code that is ignored by the compiler. It's like a secret message, and it won't be displayed or processed. They're used to leave notes for yourself or for other people reviewing your code to read. It's like a secret message. Here's an example of us using a single line comment. So what you're going to need to do is to type in 2 forward slashes, and you can see on my screen that this text became a green color, and we can write a comment here. So perhaps for a comment, I'll write lyrics for a song that I enjoy. So if we were to run this program, it's not actually going to display this comment. And you can see that it skipped it. It's basically like a secret message for yourself or for somebody else that's looking over this code. So you can also write a multi-line comment. All text that you want to be included within a multi-line comment should begin with a forward slash, followed by a asterisk, and you'll notice that all this text now became green because we're saying that we want all of this to become a comment, everything after these two characters. So you'll want to put a ending position for where you want this comment to end if it's on multiple lines. So let's say that we want our comment to end here. What we need to type is then asterisk and then a forward slash. So everything within here will be a comment, and we can add multiple lines to here. Like, I can say something such as, these lyrics are actually very good. All right, so then let's run this. And all of this will be ignored. It's like a secret message that either I myself can read or other people can read. Well, that will conclude this topic on writing output, escape sequences, comments, and a few other things I forgot to discuss in the first lesson. So in the next lesson, I'll be teaching you guys about variables. But yeah, that will conclude this topic on some of the fundamentals of C++. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.